Welcome back. Earlier this week, we told you about this woman named Bari Weiss. She was a columnist at the New York Times. She has resigned because of how she was treated after voicing her concerns about including and diverse voices at the New York Times. And to be clear, she's an admitted and avowed liberal, but she still was called some pretty horrible and anti-Semitic things. We've reached out to the New York Times for comment, but we've not heard back about why, what they're doing about this. But our next guest, Morton Klein, he's the president of the Zionist Organization of America. He's doing something. His organization set up a hotline to help people who face scrutiny for being pro-Israel at the New York Times. Morton, thanks for your time today.
Thanks for letting people know about our important hotline.
You bet. So tell me, was this done just in reaction to the New York Times? And have you heard back from the New York Times at all?
I sent a letter yesterday to the editor of the New York Times, Mr. Sulzberger. He has not responded to me. I told him that ZOA has set up a hotline. We'd like to work with him to set up a process where if people are having problems with respect to anti-Semitism, bullying, hatred toward them because they're pro-Israel positions, we'd like to help them try and resolve this. They have not gotten back to us. We've already had a number of journalists call us. We've even had two major talk show hosts call us and tell us that they've been having problems. And we're planning, by the way, to advertise this hotline in secular papers around the country.
Just to be clear, none of those talk show hosts are from Newsmax, right?
That is correct. We've been waiting.
Okay, good.
We've been waiting for your call. Apparently, things are okay at Newsmax.
Yeah, they are. Trust me.
And Morton, can anyone call into this hotline? Is this just for journalists and those in broadcasting, or is this for anyone who might be experiencing bullying in the workforce?
This is primarily journalists, people in the media, but we have been well known for decades to help college students, Jewish college students who've been experiencing anti-Semitism, harassment, and uncomfortable lectures that with lies about Israel. So we've had very great success in using Title VI to protect Jewish students. So if students want to call us, that's fine. They're having that problem. But this is primarily for journalists and people in the media.
So what happens when they call? You mentioned a couple of these folks that have called. What do you, like, what's the process? Do you sit down and connect them with someone? Are there people at the organization who try to counsel them? What's the process?
We have a bunch of full-time lawyers who work for ZOA in our Center for Law and Justice, it's called. And we first look as to whether there's a legal problem that we could go through the courts. We also will be sending letters to the New York Times or other newspapers whether there's such a problem, asking for meetings concerning these issues, putting out public press releases, leafleting, even protesting in front of the New York Times or other newspapers' buildings. And in one of the cases, we're going to go to the Human Rights Commission because it's clearly an anti-Semitic issue. So those are the things that we're able to do and wish to do to help people suffering anti-Semitism and enmity toward them because they're Jewish or because they're pro-Israel.
Mort, where do you go if someone wants to look up the hotline and get information? What's your website and how can they find you?
Our hotline is 212-481-1500. Leave a message. We'll be back to you very quickly. And our email is info@zoa.org, info@zoa.org, 212-481-1500. Leave a message. We return every single phone call, every message, whether you're a college student or whether you're a journalist in the media or even talk show host. We're happy to even help them.
Okay, well, I'm glad to know that it's not going to be a problem for anyone at Newsmax. But thanks for doing this. Thanks for sharing it with us. And I look forward to getting you back at some point and getting a heads up to see how many folks in the New York Times have called and whether or not you get a response to your letter.
And people can look at our website, zoa.org, and learn more about this. And we're honored to have honored Christopher Ruddy, a guy that's pretty well known at the Newsmax.
He is very well known here. Well, thank you for the work that you guys are doing at ZOA. Appreciate it.
Well, it's great to be with you. Thank you.
All right. Well, when we come back, Lindsay, Mark Halperin, and Joe Connison are taking this week's company quiz. Lindsay's defending her title. Let's see how it goes. Don't miss anything. Come on right back.